The folks got after her.
Leave her.
Oh, boy, we used to get balled out for doing that.
You
But
girls
it was
were
fun.
cute. You were so cute. You know where you get
that
those cheeks
fun.
Now and that little nose, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I was a puny little thing with a little nose.
So Martha's hair is not naturally curly. Whose
yeah,
is?
Yeah, naturally curly.
Martha's is?
Mm-hmm.
Can't believe how gorgeous
Mabel's
her hair
was too.
Was.
Mabel's was too. Addie's wasn't. Addie and mine was straight. But Martha gave us permanents and
uh-huh.
curled our hair up for us.
This tree's in the background of some of the pictures we had.
Yep.
A tree right there.
Must be in the yard.
These are sure a lot easier to see than those copies, aren't they?
This is Addie and I.
Mabel and Joe there. Yeah. Mabel, Joe, and Martha.
I didn't have no good pictures of Addie. Late, you know, before she died.
How old was she when she died?
40.
Was she?
Childbirth.
She realized.
Oh. This is who? It says Amline, I think. I don't know.
Martha?
Martha.
I was guessing.
Yeah,
she had Clive was in bed with pneumonia when she died.
Aww.
And Carol was 11 years old.
There you go. Look how gorgeous you were.
Wow, gorgeous.
Alice Millsap.
You know
is
there's
your
very few of them living?
Yeah, that's a cousin of mine.
Alice, yeah. Alice is living. And there's another boy in there is living. There's only three or four of us living.
Yeah.
That's a whole bunch.
Alice and her husband married 68 years this fall.
They married 65.
Mm-hmm. Well, those are friends. Okay.
Esther Plonsky.
Esther Plonsky.
Oh.
I should have marked him.
Hey, you marked him kind of.
Is Fred older than you? Or
Fred?
Fred?
No, he's younger.
He's the youngest
yeah,
of
he's
the
youngest.
Okay.
Fred the Plonsky kids were good friends of ours. We used to go swimming all the time with them.
Plonsky's used to run a grocery store there, you know, ran the
they
place
were nice
there.
People.
All the farmers, they'd take their eggs and
the
butter and everything down and trade with groceries, and he'd take them Spokane to the place, and he'd get groceries and bring back to sell to them.
Oh, wow.
Have any of them.
Now,
you
that
are.
Was the, right next to Fred's
is
house is the old original.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
That's original. How old is that store, probably?
Oh, gee, that must be
old.
It was there when you guys were kids?
It was
yeah.
when I remember anything, it was there.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the old bridge used to go
yeah.
across the
well,
river.
Well, when the folks come out here in the 1800s, the old man Plonsky, that would be Frederick's grandpa, great-grandpa, he had all his houses and they bought the land from him. He'd sell them 80 acres of a house on and a barn and everything for $1,500.
Oh,
you know, that's big money them days.
Yeah.
And in fact, all them old houses up in there, the old man Plunkey built.
Wow.
Okay, who is this? I'm confused. Who's Andy?
Mm-hmm. Oh. What? How many bedrooms in my house? What are you doing? Tell them what it is. What you're taking a picture of, girl?
Because her sister told her to.
This is the original homestead of Leverett and Florence Lyons.
Restored.
With an addition. There's my cute brother Mike. Behind him is the silo that Leverett built by hand. Pretty amazing. In Post Falls, Idaho.
I can't believe we were in Plenty of you. No, I think it is Post Falls.
With Mike.
Not Plenty
of you.
Present.
Is it cute?
Present.
Funny.
Hey guys, you could look over here and say
no,
hello.
We don't like our picture taken.
Just one.
Okay, goodbye.
This is right.
Father is all upstairs here.
Yep.
This is the grave of my great uncle.
That was
son
it.
Of William and Matilda
Lyons.
It's
just
Lyons.
Absolutely absurd. 3 miles of film in the in the...
He died...
Suitcase.
At how old, Mike? 39?
He was 39.
39, he drowned swimming in the Spokane River. River.
And Leverett 59. Died at...
And this is my great-grandfather.
79 years old.
Leverett...
Benning.
Benning Ryan. He died in 1940. He was born in 1861. We are in Post Falls, Idaho.
Mm-hmm.
At what cemetery, Mike?
Isn't this Evergreen? It's only.
That smells good. I didn't know.
Okay, this is my dad's grave at Norman Hill Cemetery in section 35.
In Lewiston.
In Lewiston, Idaho. And we just did some trimming. The rose bush that's planted. Oh, you can see my shadow, isn't that bizarre? Bubba Donald M. Lyon, March 14th, 1930. What does that say, Mary?
35.
Okay. To April 24th, 1972. Evidently, Grandma Mabel bought this headstone and put it there. And there's little Shelby. She's going to put some flowers down. For her grandfather that she never got to meet.
Yep.
And there's lots of bees. Hey, Shelby, you can look at me and see how cute you are. Thanks.
Yep. Oh, I could take a picture too. Here, hold it.
Section 37, and how we find this, we figured out, is straight down from that building. So next time, we don't have to spend 2 hours trying to find the place. Beautiful cemetery. And Mike and Molly are taking care of all the rose bush leaves. Here they come now. My dad's widow, Molly. Lion's Beal, and there's my
hungry
brother, Mike.
Turn your camera off before I break it.
God, I love him. He loves having this picture taken.
Thank you.